Hello guys, welcome back to Let's Play Undertale for our 8th installment here. Let's get the mouse out of the way. We're right outside the throne room, but we will take a quick detour down to the most morbid room in the castle. I missed the pretty music from earlier. It's a coffin. There's a name engraved on it. Emery. It's empty. It's as comfortable as it looks. No. It's actually not our coffin. But it's kind of sad that they... Well, I'm not sure why they... I don't know if monsters... Oh, it's because monsters don't bury their dead. Because their dead turn into dust and they spread their ashes over things. So I guess they didn't really know what to do with the human bodies. We're about to go face Asgore here. Actually... Well, you know, we'll try it, and if I fail, then I'll go back and buy more healing items. Dum-dee-dum. Oh, is someone there? Just a moment. I have almost finished watering these flowers. Here we are. How do you walk through here without stepping all over your flowers? Howdy! How can I? Yeah. Oh. I so badly want to say, would you like a cup of tea? But, you know how it is. Doesn't have to be that way, bro. Nice day today, huh? I wouldn't know. Birds are singing. Flowers are blooming. Perfect weather for a game of catch. Do you have to make it overdramatic? You know what we must do. When you are ready, come into the next room. Well, we don't have to do this, bud. It's another throne covered by white sheet. Him. How tense. Just think of it like a visit to the dentist. Why would I? I would never want to think of it as a visit to the dentist, so. Random off branch, but my family has a lot of teeth troubles, and every time I go to the dentist, I have a new problem to deal with. Like right now, I have to get a fake tooth. So, yeah, no, I don't want to think of it as a trip to the dentist. I really don't. Are you ready? If you are not, I understand. I'm not ready either. Well, great. Can we talk this out, then? This is the barrier. This is what keeps us all trapped underground. If by chance you have any unfinished business, please, do what you must. Yeah, that means he said that the sound under these men, he said, continue or go back. But yes, we're gonna try this. I see. I haven't died yet. I get the feeling this is about to change. This is it, then. So it is. Ready? No. Gee, thanks. I'm so glad those are in front of me. A strange light fills the room. Twilight is shining through the barrier. I thought it was 3 o'clock in the evening. It seems your journey is finally over. You're filled with determination. Human. It was nice to meet you. Goodbye. Not the mercy button. Also, yeah, thanks for the interface, screw. Alright. Let's start this off right. Darn it. long enough. There we go. Recollection flashes in his eyes. That center as I can. Ugh. Oh, I missed. Don't eat, quiche. Away from me. About a third of the way down. Okay. Whew. Those get faster as you go on. The only time in the past of this run we were forced to fight. Okay. Goodness. Almost halfway. Believe I can do it. Oh. Wow. You're getting a little extra with those. I'm halfway. Alright. Okay. Hey, hot dog, question mark? Good. Okay. Just gotta live. So close. I think I got this. There we go. I'm guessing you don't kill him immediately because your heart's not in it. So that is how it is. I remember the day after my son died. The entire underground was devoid of hope. The future had once again been taken from us by the humans. In a fit of anger, I declared war. They said that I would destroy any human that came here. I would use their souls to become godlike and free us from this terrible prison. But your heart wasn't in it, which is why you didn't just take a soul and cross the barrier and go take the rest. Then I would destroy humanity and let monsters rule the surface in peace. Soon the people's hopes returned. My wife, however, became disgusted with my actions. Even the actions of killing kids. You have kids' bodies in your basement. She left this place, never to be seen again. Truthfully, I do not want power. I do not want to hurt anyone. I just wanted everyone to have hope. but I cannot take this any longer. I just want to see my wife. I just want to see my child. Please, young one. This war has gone on long enough. You have the power. It's not so much of a war if you just occasionally kill people that fall down here. More like a series of skirmishes. Take my soul and leave this cursed place. I like to envision that your little kid just went around the room after that and picked up all the mercy pieces and kind of like stuck them back together. This works, right? After everything I have done to hurt you, you would rather stay down here and suffer than live happily on the surface? Look, I don't think I was happy on the surface, so I mean, at least down here, I got some good buddies. Human, I promise you, for as long as you remain here, my wife and I will take care of you as best we can. Does she want to? We can sit in the living room, telling stories, eating butterscotch pie. Butterscotch cinnamon pie? We could be like a family. And then all that hope is just crushed. Because it's the world's biggest asshole flower. Hi, Flowey. You idiot! You haven't learned a thing in this world. It's kill or be killed. Gee, thanks. And we're back in. Long ago, two races ruled over Earth, humans and monsters. One day, they all disappeared without a trace. Yep. Oh, Flowey, how you love to ruin things. Continue, restart. I wonder which I should do. It doesn't matter. Little save point in the dark. What if I just walk past it? Okay, I can't. What a great little sunflower. Actually, are you a buttercup? I don't remember. Howdy! It's me, Flowey. Flowey the flower! I owe you a huge thanks. You really did a number on that old fool. Well, I mean, it's not like he gave me an option. Without you, I never could have gotten past him. But now, with your help, he's dead. And I've got the human souls. Boy, I've been empty for so long. Feels great to have a soul inside me again. I can feel them wriggling. Ugh. I just imagine them, like, envision them swapping around like fish in a tank or something. you're feeling left out, aren't you? No. Well, that's just perfect. After all, I only have 6 souls. I still need one more before I become God. What sort of... Is 7 just the limit? Because I thought 7 was only the barrier on how many you needed to, like, break the barrier. But maybe 7 is, like, the limit to become God in this world? Who knows? And then, with my newfound powers, monsters, humans, everyone, I'll show them all the real meaning of this world. Kill or be killed? Oh, and forget about escaping to your old save file. It's gone forever. Liar. But don't worry. Your old friend Flowey has worked out a replacement for you. Oh, gee. I wonder what it could be. I'll save over your own death so you can watch me tear you to bloody pieces over and over and over. That sounds great. What? Do you really think you can stop me? I also like to note that that's another point in the game where your character takes a step forward on their own. Like, they've decided they're going to stop Flowey. Hee hee hee. You really are an idiot. But I'm an idiot with a big heart! Da da da. Now for one of the weirdest designs in the game. Actually, we'll see if I die here or not. We're gonna give it the old go ahead. Okay. I didn't die at Asgore, so. Your best nightmare. Here we go. Oh, you're starting with this one. Oh, God. Oh God. One damage! I didn't try to aim for that much. Christ, Christ, Christ. Don't die! Oh, I'm almost dead! No! Okay. Save me, Blue Heart. Patience. Oh. I'm pretty sure you can't die on this screen. Help! Help! Okay. Thank you. Ah! What even are those? Oh god. Five damage! I'm getting better! Ah! This music is sincerely creepy as well. Oh. Whew. Can't stop me with your Venus flytrap, Flowey. You can't do it. Our hands. That's a tough glove. This is, bravery? Yeah. Second human. He's the one that owned the tough glove and the bandana. Ooh. Gotta get enough health, yeah. Heal me, heal me, heal me, heal me, heal me. No, not enough. Okay. Stop! Stop that! Stop it! Rude! Yeah, he loads files on you. Oh god, stop. Make sure you get hit. Oh, that seemed a lot shorter. Integrity. We got this. Remain true to who you are. Even if that is a ballerina in an underground monster pit. I'm pretty sure Integrity is the one that killed the most monsters while they were here. Yeah. Help me. There we go. Integrity turned purple. Christ. Stop. Ooh. Ow. I'm getting reamed in this one. Don't die! Ah! Oh no, I'm gonna die! Oh, oh. Oh shit, I'm screwed, I'm screwed, I'm screwed! Okay. That was a toughie. Okay. Nightmare Despair. This is Perseverance? Heal me, heal me, heal me! Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, I need more than that, oh no. Stop loading files on me! Ow. I think I saw somebody do a no-hit of this thing, I don't know how they managed it. Oh. Kindness. Green is kindness. That's the one that had the apron and the frying pan. I think I like this refrain of your best nightmare the best. Gimme. Help. Thank you, eggs, donuts, whatever you are. Okay. Not quite full health, but best I'm gonna get. Stop, 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 stop. Oh no! Oh. So are you only limited by your imagination and the attacks you can pull out on me, or...? Stop! Okay. Justice! This is the one with the gun. Stop shooting me! Stop, stop, stop! He also had the cowboy hat. Whew. All six of them. United in being humans, I guess. Or not being used by an evil flower, at least. Oh no, I missed a music note. Alright, we got this. Probably my favorite battle theme in the song, in the game. Gets me pumped every time. It's like, yeah, you can't stop me, evil flower! I got determination! Strongest quality of all. Yes. As long as I keep getting those healing items. Oh my god. This battle still impresses me even now. Healing items, you can do it. You can make it. Something endearing about the fact is just your soul taking on this giant monster. Very culmination of your being. No! This can't be happening! You! Yeah, but save states. You idiot. Gee, thanks. Still didn't die, though. Well, I guess I die like a million times right here, but, yeah. No. Time for an Easter egg. Who's patient? I'm patient. Okay. Right. Hopeless and alone. Golly, that's right. Your worthless friends. Can't save you now. Call for help, I dare you. Cry into the darkness. Mommy, Daddy, somebody help.
I don't know if I want to call for my parents. I think I was willing to wander up a mountain that nobody ever returns from just to get away from them.
See what good it does you.
You called for help?
But nobody came. Boy, what a shame. Nobody else is gonna get to see you die.
You forgot there's six other people here, bud.
Yep. How'd you? Well, I'll just...
That's right, load fail, biatch!
Okay. What? Where are my powers?
Right there.
The souls? What are they doing? No, no! You can't do that! You're supposed to obey me! Stop! Stop it! Stop. Seizure much?
most unfair choice in the game. It's even replaying this, y'all, I just want to, how about I just kill you? Because he's been nothing but cruel and evil to you this entire time. It's obvious that he's done this many times. Well, at least not the souls thing, but he's, you know, he's gone on an evil murderous rampage more than once. And he hasn't done anything that is deserving of your mercy. Like, nothing. Which is why this is the hardest choice in the game, I think. I mean, I see so many people agonizing over this. But in the end, even the cruelest person, you gotta be better than him. What are you doing? Do you really think I've learned anything from this? No, I don't. No. But I'm gonna teach you. Sparing me won't change anything. Killing me is the only way to end this. If you let me live, I'll come back. But I'll beat you again. I'll kill you. Yeah, but then I just can reload the game. I'll kill everyone. I think you've already done that. I'll kill everyone you love! Can't stop me. I can stop you, though. Why? Because even you should get a reset on this whole life. It sucks. Why are you being so nice to me? I can't understand. I can't understand. You don't need to understand. I just can't understand. Flowey ran away. With those legs that he totally has. Also, he must have restored my save file. Somehow. And you can't go back. This is the eternal question, is how did Frisk get past the barrier here? Because it takes at least a human soul and a monster soul, and Flowey destroyed Asgore's soul. I guess the only answer really is Flowey must have left you just past the barrier, like dropped you off here. And here we now get the neutral ending. Because the game makes you. With the much more boring credits. Dun 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 dun. Guest monster designs. Muffet and Washua. Other monster designs. Braddy and Caddy help. Like, that's a specific title of job. Translator? Japanese graphics. Oh yeah, I forgot that the Japanese version's available on the computer version now. Also, the Japanese version confirms that Sans is the older brother to Papyrus, because Papyrus calls him, like, the informal version for older brother at one point. Hey, is anyone there? I'm right here. Well, I'll just leave a message. So, it's been a while. The Queen returned, and is now ruling under the underground. She's instated a new policy. All the humans who fall down here will be treated not as enemies, but as friends. It's probably for the best, anyway. The human souls the King gathered seem to have disappeared. Yeah. So, that plan ain't happening anytime soon. I wonder where they went. I have no idea how the afterlife is supposed to work in this universe, so, like, maybe they went to heaven, or wherever else they were supposed to go. Who knows? But even though people are heartbroken over the King, and things are looking grim for our freedom, the Queen's trying her best not to let us give up hope. So, hey. If we're not giving up down here, don't give up wherever you are, okay? Who knows how long it will take. But we will get out of here. Sans, who are you talking to? Oh, nobody. What? Nobody? Can I talk to them too? I wonder if there's a person named Nobody. I wouldn't even doubt it at this point. Here, knock yourself out.
Wait a second. I recognize this number. Attention, human. I, the Great Papyrus, am now Captain of the Royal Guard. It's everything I've ever dreamed of. Except, instead of fighting, We just water flowers.
I bet you're the world's best gardener.
So that's ever so slightly different.
Ever slightly.
And we're helping Dr. Alphys with the research. She's gonna find a way to get us out of here. And Dinah's helping her too. Though, to be honest, her method of helping seems kind of explosion-inducing.
Just Undyne working in a lab.
But I think Alphys likes having her around. Uh-oh.
Hey, what are you up to, punk?
Ah. Please don't noogie the phone.
Hey, who's in charge here?
Me.
Oh yeah, that's right. I quit my job as leader of the Royal Guard. Actually, since we won't be fighting anymore. The Royal Guard totally disbanded. There's, only one member now.
But he's extremely good.
That's right.
Yeah, he is. Come here. Please don't noogie the skeleton.
Anyways, now I'm working as Alice's lab assistant. We're gonna find a way out of this dump once and for all. Oh, yeah, and I'm on a gym teacher at the Queen's New School. Did you know I can bench press 7 children? It's pretty awesome. Hey, I'm sorry about what happened with Asgore. You were just doing what you had to.
I didn't kill him.
It was an evil flower. It's not your fault, Yeah, it's not. Ah, darn it. I miss the big guy. Come on, Undyne. Snap out of it. I guess you guys don't have Santa Claus anymore, right? I guess I'll tell you how Alphys is doing. Well, she's the same as ever. Maybe a little more reclusive than normal. Seems like something's really bothering her. But she can get through it. I'm there supporting her. That's what friends are for, right? Hey, wherever you are, I hope it's better than here. Took a lot of sacrifices for you to get there. So, wherever you are, you have to try to be happy, okay? For our sakes. Considering how miserable I must have been, I don't even know how Frisk does in the neutral ending. Could be terrible. We'll feel better knowing our trouble was worth it. We're all with you. Everyone is. Even the Queen. Hey, wait a second. Toriel, do you wanna... Heh. She says she's busy.
But if she knew who we were talking to...
We wouldn't get the phone back for at least a few hours.
We have the mercy to spare you from her!
Oh, come on. But call back anytime, okay? She'd love to talk. Oh, whoops. This thing's almost out of batteries, so... Hate to cut this short, but... Be seeing you, okay, buddy?
Bye-bye for now!
We will be seeing you shortly.
See ya, punk!
Again.
Why?
Why did you let me go? Don't you realize that being nice just makes you get hurt?
At least I don't sacrifice my integrity as a good person.
Look at yourself. You made all these great friends, but now you'll probably never see them again. That's life, buddy. Not to mention how much they've been set back by you.
By me? It's your fault.
Hurts, doesn't it?
You're the one who let all the souls go. You can't pin that on me. So no, it doesn't hurt. Screw you, Flowey.
If you had just gone through without caring about anyone, this game would have been a lot more morose. You wouldn't have to feel bad now.
I don't feel bad. I didn't feel bad the first time I played this either, and I was at the screen. I was like, come on, I did my best. It was your fault that everything got messed up. Don't try to pin that on me. Bruh.
So I don't get it. If you really did everything the right way, why did things still end up like this? Why? Is life really that unfair?
Yes. Yes, it is. But that doesn't mean you stop being kind or caring just because life is unfair sometimes.
Say, what if I told you I knew some way to get you a better ending? You'll have to load your save file and...
Didn't you erase that? I guess not.
Well, in the meantime, why don't you go see Dr. Alphys? It seems like you could have been better friends. Who knows? Maybe she's got the key to your happiness.
Maybe. I wonder what you're talking about, Flowey. I wonder how you know this.
See you soon.
Don't like that little grin you got going on there, bud. Yep. But, alright. So instead of fighting the king, we're just gonna head back. Also, yeah, this must be the barrier. Since the barrier is nearby, this is really close to the surface, so I imagine this light and the bird you can hear. The above ground must be right up there. Maybe there's some holes in the ceiling of the cavern. back through the Judgment Hall with its dramatic shading. Yeah, it's like, although Undertale isn't the most pretty of games or extravagant, it does have some really good moments. This kind of reminds me of Journey. There's a scene in Journey, although perhaps a little prettier. There's a scene in Journey where you glide on this path through a ruined city and there's just the sun setting and it's completely golden. It's really fantastic. Journey's a good game, too. Oh, we can use the elevator now. Make things go a little faster. Since everything's dead quiet now. Alright. Back to the core. And your kid still looks completely unperturbed by all of this. Oh yes, I've just reset. You know, I've just reloaded the universe after defeating a giant evil flower monster. I wish I could be so unaffected by such things. Instead, I was sitting there staring at my screen when that mercy kill option came up going, Og, why do you do this to me? I just want to kill the flower, but now I feel like I can't. Because he wants me to. And even if an evil person came up to me and were like, kill me, I want you to kill me, I'd be like, well, no, because you want that. And I don't want to give you what you want. I don't want to give evil people what they desire. Hey, this is Undyne. Shut up, Papyrus. This was your idea. This was Papyrus's. Human, you have to deliver something for me. Please. I'm at Snowden in front of Papyrus's. See ya, punk. Yeah, because we know that Papyrus talks to Flowey from a little interaction quite a while, long while ago. Actually, I still have the mystery key, don't I? We can go to... Hang on. Where did I have it? It's not in the second box. It's in... Hey, yes. Okay. Mystery key. I don't need anything else right now. We'll keep the snow in peace too. We gotta get back to the river person. And then we'll go to Waterfall and we'll find out what that key is used for finally. Hey, hey! Did you remember my name? Oh, I forgot to come back to you, didn't I? Yeah, Flame Seedsman. How could I be so easily defeated? Okay. It's R1? Or L1? I think it might be L1. Yeah, it's L1. That's just the image of the core. There we go. These elevator trips are much faster. Since the royal guards are no longer blocking that middle section there. Hello! Care for a ride? Yes, I do. We need to go to... Napstablook's neighbor first. What will you say to me today, oh mysterious river person? La la la. I should have worn a few more pairs of pants today. How many are you wearing now? Come again sometime. Yeah, I'll be back shortly. Oh, it's to the left, yes. And we finally made it. Oh, do I have to actually... Hang on. There we go. The key disappeared. Was it a ghost key? Dear Diary, Shiren's sister fell down recently. It's sad. Without her sister to speak for her, she'd become more reclusive than ever. So I reached out to her, and I told her that she, Bluki, and I would all perform together sometime. She seemed to like the idea. Dearer Diary, I'd like to buy a new diary for every entry I make. I'd love to collect diaries. What a waste of paper. Dearest Diary, our cousin left the farm to become a training dummy. That leaves just Bluki and I. Bluki asked me if I was going to try to become corporeal too. They sounded so... resigned. Come on, Bluki. You'd know I'd never leave you behind. Don't lie. And besides, I'd never find the kind of body I'm looking for, anyway.
My darling diary, I met someone interesting today. Last week I posted that advertisement for my human fan club. Today was our first meeting. Only one other person came. Honestly, she's a dork, and she's obsessed with these awful cartoons. But she's kind of funny, too. I want to see her again. Diary, my dear, my diary collection is going fabulously. I have like 5 now. Dear diary, she surprised me with something today. Sketches of a body that she wants to create for me, a form beyond my wildest fantasies. In a form like that, I could finally feel like myself. After all, there's no way I can be a star the way I am now. Sorry, Blukey, my dreams can't wait for anyone. It's like, oh, there's no way I'll leave you behind. 3 diaries later, my dreams can't wait for anybody. Also, this kind of the stars kind of remind me of, like, Steven Universe or something. But yeah, this is Metaton's house, in case you couldn't guess. Can I call people in here? What? You broke into Napster Blue Cousin's house? Well, I mean, I have the key. That's, hey. What was their name anyway? Hapstabluke, the happy ghost. Okay, that's definitely wrong. It's not wrong, it's just my headcanon. So we have Hapstabluke and, Spooky Blue Blue, I believe is what he called him earlier. I want Papyrus to give me a headcanon name. Be good with it. Oops. Boat's over here. Now we can finally head to Snowden and do what Undyne wants us to do. Oops. The nice thing is now that we're past that Omega Flowey fight, the game doesn't necessarily have to ever be closed again, I'm pretty sure. Or it won't close automatically. Why don't you string with me? Tra-la-la. I don't know the tune. Is it the traditional ballad of the river people? Or are you the only river person? I'll be coming back shortly. Back to the delightful Snowden music. Do these people say anything new? Oh, okay, so it's the same as before. Past the library. Oh, hold on. I forgot that I could do this. Hello, that's not my house. That's just my cool tool shed. Do you call it your cool shed? No, I've never thought of that. That's why we're friends, Undyne. You enrich my life with shed-based puns. That's the only one I've ever made, dude. I'm sure you'll make more in the future. Anyway. So, I have a favor to ask you. I need to deliver this letter to Dr. Alphys. Huh? Why don't I do it myself? Well... It's kind of personal, but we're friends, so... I'll tell you. Hotland sucks. I don't want to have to go over there. So here you go. Oh, and if you read it, I'll kill you. Thanks so much. You're the best. Well, I don't want it to invite Undyne's wrath upon me, so I'll just go deliver it. Yeah, we gotta go to Hotland now. We got some mail to deliver. I'm now the official mailman of the Underground. What you got, river person? Tra-la-la, the water is very dry today. I've had, like, dry sparkling water. It does taste... odd? It's hard to describe. You drink it and somehow your mouth doesn't feel like you've actually swallowed a liquid. We'll actually cut this episode off early because there's a lot of stuff we're gonna go through here. So, I will see all you guys in the next episode. But yeah, see you all later.